What I like about the ocean, what draws me to it, is just the mystery and beauty of how it circulates, how it moves around, and how it operates. One of the things about being an oceanographer is you get to go out on a ship and make measurements at sea, and one of the bad parts about that is the ships are so expensive you don't get to do it very often. That's why we have been developing Deepglider. A glider can operate now for about a year for the cost of one day of ship time. We develop Sea Glider, and then Deep Glider is the variant that goes six times deeper. Goes to 6,000 meter depth.
Attention please, the pressure vessel will be in operation for the next 4 hours. The maximum pressure will be 10,000 PSI. As the potential risk is higher than normal, evacuation of the building is required.
A Deep Glider is an autonomous underwater vehicle. It weighs about 150 pounds, about 75 kilograms. It also uses energy very parsimoniously. It can run on about a third of a watt. With a fixed battery pack, it means that the projected endurance is about a year and a half, and the projected range is about 10,000 kilometers, that is a quarter of the way around the world. It measures temperature and salinity and dissolved oxygen. We can tell where the water goes and where it comes from by its character in terms of its combined temperature, salinity, and dissolved oxygen. I'm getting old, and it would be nice to see this technology continue. I'm starting to see signs that there's considerable demand for it. We're getting calls from various places around the world saying, gee, can we do this too? Can we get hold of one of the deep gliders? Fortunately, we're in a position where we can sell them to them and start spreading this technology around. Maybe someday we'll have hundreds or thousands of gliders marching around the world, and that will be a mainstay of the data stream of oceanographers.